Niggas is caught up in the midst of sex. You better grab a hold of your crucifix. And this is it, the black god exists. But can you understand this? Let me teach you a lesson. Yo, the pre-existence of the mathematical biochemical equations, the manifestation of our plan.
Alles klar, wie eben versprochen, sitzen jetzt hier mit Grave Diggers. Like I said, I'm gonna speak German to the people, English to you guys. The best thing to start off is will probably be if you introduce yourself to the audience so people know, you know, who we talking to.
Yo, what's up, Prince Paul? How you feeling?
Yo, I got stress on my
peace. Coming in the name of Fuquan, the gatekeeper representing Grave Diggers.
Alice Clyde. It's Poetic the Grim Reap, maintaining the Grave Digger Stilo, you know what I mean?
Also my man the RZA, you know what I'm saying, who's out walking the dogs, making po-po, you know what I'm saying? Peace.
Im Moment machen wir das Interview, weil die Jungs ein neues Album rausgebracht haben. Es gab vorher schon ein Album, da werde ich die Jungs erstmal mal fragen, womit die angefangen haben. We're sitting here together because you guys came out with the second album. There was like an album before that, and there was like an EP that I have at home. So maybe tell us how the album was called, the first one, when it came out. So just to let people know, you know, when how things got started with, you know, Grave Diggers and all that.
First album was 6 feet deep. You know what I'm saying? That came out like in August 94, you know, to be exact. The album was the foundation, stepping stone to the whole Grave Digger future. The whole Grave Digger empire, you know what I'm saying, which enters the second stage now, you know what I'm saying. Album number two is called The Pick, the Sickle, and the Shovel, you know what I'm saying. That'll be out September 16th. First single off the album is Dangerous Minds, and I pass it to my man, let me finish it off at the end of the line.
Space. Like I said, first single is Dangerous Minds. Actually, out here, I think it's going to be an earlier release. I think the record gets released over here a week early. So you'll probably catch it like September 9th or something like that. Lucky y'all, right? Yeah, but on this album, The Pick, the Sickle, and the Shovel, like you said, it's the continuing saga. We started off with 6 feet deep, which was kind of dark, kind of still dealing with the ghetto situations that we encounter over in the States, and I guess it's now worldwide conditions of poor people, I guess underclassmen, you would say, people who are not economically empowered to the highest potential that they could be, you know. So we took all those pressures and we made an album about it. The second saga is more light, because light and dark is comparative, whereas you can see the stars and the sun, you can see the stars and the moon at night against a dark background, then you know they're light. But the sun, the moon and the stars are out right now, but also the sun is out, which is a brighter light, and we can't see it. So we gave you something to compare to, so that you can see the light now in the second album, you know. So what we want you all to do, you can do your research, go back and get 6 feet deep at your local stores, just for research purposes, of course. Then after that, you pick up the new one, Pick, the Sickle, and the Shovel, and you'll be able to see what kind of methods that we bring to this hip-hop culture, techniques, you know.
Also with Grave Diggers, when we started out, you know, it's like individuals, other forces, you know, who ain't want to see hip-hop expand, you know what I'm saying, gave us a label of Horrorcore, which Grave Diggers, ourselves as a whole, we don't worship the devil, you know what I'm saying, we ain't into Satanism or anything of that nature, you know what I'm saying. What we do is deal with the mentally dead. That's those who lack the knowledge of self, meaning those who walk around who don't even know their existence on this planet, you know what I'm saying. So what we doing, we ain't digging graves to put corpse in them. we digging mental graves so that we can bring you out your state of ignorance and so to speak, unawareness of your own self. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, the first album was like man versus himself. You know what I'm saying? Whereas the second album, man already see the light. You know what I'm saying? And it's like under like a track air like rappel. It's like now he's the piece with magnetic. His job now is to go out and attract those who ain't got magnetic and give them power, which everyone can attract at the same time. Right. You know what I'm saying? So we on that now.
Let me roll into a video, otherwise I'm running out of questions if you answer everything before I ask it. Wir gucken uns jetzt ein Video an, wir sind gleich wieder da. Gleich wieder da. Peace. Was ich wissen möchte, ist, zwei von den Jungs haben angefangen mit That's a Sonic früher, back in the days. Und ich will wissen, wie der Wandel kommt von That's a Sonic, von der Message, von der Art und Weise, wie sie sich damals präsentiert haben, jetzt zu Grave Diggers. I was just saying that two of you guys started off when I'm right with, you know, That's a Sonic, that's back in the days. And I know, but, you know, people need to know. And you know, my man right here was producing parts for, or he was producing Three for High and Rising for that assault. So I was wondering, I was asking myself how, like, you start off with something with like a flavor with, you know, Sessa Sonic and with Data Soul, and then kind of change the whole thing into like a different color. Because I mean, Gravediggers, you're saying it's not about digging graves, but yeah, instead it's like a bit dark and creepier than you guys started off with. So how that happened?
I mean, for me, musically, it's just all the transitions. It's the part of maturing and being more creative music-wise. I mean, Stetson Sonic was known as a hip-hop band. De La Soul is known for, I guess, more or less, you know, the ill, offbeat, native tongue style. And now Gravediggers more or less represents more of a knowledgeable style. So it's just like a transition, just a growing process that I've been going through. It's just different styles, different techniques, you know, different ways to express yourself musically. So, you know, I don't see any other way but to go the course that's been going so far as far as music's concerned. As for Fuquan, lyrically, I don't know, it just shows how diverse he is, you know, as far as like we first did the Stet stuff, which was in what, how long ago was that? That long ago? Yeah, I was little too, man. Yo, chill.
Yeah, yeah. Yo, it's just what it is just adding on, and still it's like what it is longevity. You know what I'm saying? Having the heart, having the will, still having the love, you know what I'm saying, to deal with the music industry, still have the power, to have fans who still buy your music, still appreciate you, you know what I'm saying? It's just being a human being or whatever, just clean being, you know? So, that's peace to my peeps. From back then, if you don't know, get the album. It's almost gold.
Sonic again. he says he's gonna start the new Stetson Sonic. Might want to ask him about it.
Serious about that?
Nah, he lying.
We're looking at some videos, Stetson Sonic, from back in the days, sind gleich wieder da. Alles klar, wir sind wieder da. Ich gucke auf meinen Zettel. I was listening to the album. I didn't get the whole album. I just got like a snippet tape with half the songs on there. But let me start off with the intro, because I didn't quite get what you guys trying to say. It might be the language problem, because English is my second language. But you was talking about, you know, that either you dig your own grave or you're a grave digger. And something like you got to dig yourself in order to dig your grave with somebody. I just didn't get the meaning.
Well, like Fuquan has said, grave diggers, we represent, we're not trying to dig a grave to physically put anybody in. There's two things you could do when you dig a grave. You can be digging a place in, or you can be exhuming, which means it's like a hand coming down and pulling something out of darkness, out of mental ignorance, things of that nature. And in life, you have a lot of opportunities to get yourself out of certain situations, okay? This is an opportunity for you to exhume yourself. When Paul and Fuquan were with Stet, Okay, they were on Tommy Boy. When I did God Made Me Funky, I was the Tommy Boy. When RZA did When We Love You Rakim, he was the Tommy Boy, right? At one point, that label said, all right, your careers are dead. We don't think you can go any farther than this point, okay? At that point, we could have dug our own graves and also concurred and just buried ourselves, meaning not giving forth any assertiveness or showing confidence in ourselves to go against the grain when it's necessary or things of that nature. We would have, in essence, buried ourselves. But instead, we resurrected ourselves by trial and error, by perseverance, and by the knowledge that we are greater than what people say we are, you know? So in that, we dug ourselves. We invested in ourselves. And to dig, it means you go past what's superficial, what's on the surface. In order to survive that kind of situation, you have to go deep within yourself to pull that confidence out and bring it to light and take it to the next level. So when in the intro, when we say things like that, to be a grave digger, you know, you got to dig yourself. Because it starts internally. It starts right here. Then it goes out.
Dazu kann ich nicht viel sagen. Gucken noch ein Video und sind hoffentlich gleich wieder da. Ich versuche mal, die Jungs dazu bewegen, dass wir hier mal umziehen, vielleicht mal darüber gehen oder zu dem Wachturm oder so. Wir sind auf jeden Fall gleich wieder da. Also nicht umschalten bei Wordcup.